What's up YouTube, it's Sufan from TechCycle. In this video, I'm going to share guys a method to move status bar to the bottom of the screen so that you can access the settings available on the status bar very easily. So let's jump into this tutorial. Note guys, we are not officially moving the status bar to the bottom of the screen. We are just copying the status bar, or we are creating a duplicate status bar at the bottom of the screen. So if you got a tall device, this is going to be very helpful, as you don't need to swipe like this. You don't need to do that. So let's jump into this tutorial. So we are using an application called Bottom Cube Settings for this functionality. So jump into the Play Store and search for Bottom Cube Settings, or use the link in the description, or manually type in the Bottom Cube Settings on Play Store and install the application. After installing the application, open the application and enable the Bottom Cube Settings. So after enabling this Bottom Cube Settings, you can find that a new status bar is officially available for you on the bottom of the screen. Just swipe from the bottom and you can access this new status bar. But as we are handling with Android, you can't fully utilize this Bottom Cube Settings, as if you want to toggle the mobile data, immersive mode or battery saver, you need to give additional permission for this Bottom Cube Settings. We are going to give permission to this Bottom Cube Settings application by using ADB tools. You can find the step-by-step guide on this Bottom Cube Settings application. Just swipe from the side and choose ADB permission, and you can find all the step-by-step guide for giving the permission to this Bottom Cube Settings. But I'm going to make that guide easy for you guys. Also, I'm not going to go through the complete steps. You need to refer to that application, also this video, to get this job done easily. So do all the steps shown on the Bottom Cube Settings, that is enable the developer option and enable this USB debugging on your Android device, just by following the guide on that Bottom Cube Settings application. Next, for installing ADB tools, don't follow the step shown on that application. Just follow the step given over here. Just download the ADB setup given in the description. It is an XDF post. Just download that setup. I will also give the direct link in the description. You can download it from there. Download and install that application. This is going to install the ADB tools and also ADB driver. So you are going to get an easy method by following this guide. So after installing ADB, open up command prompt by typing cmd on search and opening the command prompt. Copy the command on that application or command given in the description, or just manually type in the command given on the screen to that command prompt. After that, press enter and you have successfully given permission to this Bottom Cube Settings. Now you have successfully, or you have unleashed the full power of this Bottom Cube Settings. So that's all about moving the status bar to the bottom of the screen. Now for some of the features of this Bottom Cube Settings. Before we jump into the features, I need to share you guys something, that if you want to customize the tile and customize, if you want to theme this Bottom Cube Settings, you need to purchase the premium version. If you are not purchasing the premium version, the functionality of this app is limited. That is, limited means you can't customize the tiles, also you can't theme this Bottom Cube Settings. Now for the feature on the custom tile option, some of the features that I like the most is that you can add custom application to this status bar. That is, this is going to eventually turn this Bottom Cube Settings as status bar into a quick access option. As if you want to access an application, just swipe from the bottom, choose the application, and you will be jumped into that application very fast. You don't need to go through choose the application, just swipe from the bottom and choose the application, and you will be jumped into that application very fast. So this is going to turn this status bar into a quick access application. Another feature I like that is that you can add a custom link to this status bar. So if you want to open up a link very often, you need to just add that link to the status bar. So swipe, choose the link, and you will be jumped into that web page. And other feature is that you can also add shortcut, but I don't really use shortcut that much, so can't say anything about that. But it's going to be easy like that. Swipe, choose that, and you will be done with that shortcut. And also that is providing all the regular stuff, that is mobile data, battery saver, aeroplane mode, all that regular stuff. And next, on the customizing the sliders, I just changed my height to 8 so that it is not prone to all that swiping, but it is still accessible. And I just add the small thing that is showing that there is Bottom Cube Settings, I just add that so that it will look natural. And on the theme section, I choose the dark theme because it is matching my status bar, so both are matching, and also I really love the dark theme. So that's all about this video, guys. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to subscribe.